Hi, Mike Huber, Moneyball Hitter Magazine. How's it going, everybody? Team hitting specialist, lead columnist for the magazine. We are doing team reviews, and we're continuing with the Baltimore Orioles. We're coming from you straight from the city of Chicago. Actually, it's a suburb called Naperville, Illinois, which is one of the biggest suburbs. So it is a balmy 53 degrees out in the middle of January, so a lot of people from Chicago are pretty happy about that today. We had a terrible winter last year. So the Baltimore Orioles are a team that the Moneyball Hitter magazine really, really likes. One of the few teams that we can say some positive things about, actually. They are a Moneyball hitting championship team. They have four-star hitters in the lineup that can hit over 15 home runs and hit 270 or higher. And they have some chip-in hitters who can either hit for high average or hit a lot of home runs that really chip in also. So they can hit up and down the lineup, and we really like the Baltimore Orioles. And we are not surprised they made it as far as they did. You know, if they would have didn't run into the Royals pitching staff, they would have made it to the World Series last year. They are ranked ninth in the major leagues in hitting, top 10, which is good. They're a 256 hitting team, which is very average. But they hit the most home runs in the major leagues. They were up in the top five at least. Okay, they are. There's some people think they may be in trouble. And here at Moneyball, we want to discuss this and let you Baltimore Orioles fans know that, you know, are you going to miss Nelson Cruz, who had 40 home runs and 270, and he had 270 also. Are you guys going to miss? Who else did you guys miss? His name is Nick Markakis, who hit 14 home runs, and he was a 271 hitter. Okay, so are you going to miss those guys? It's a lot of home runs. It's a lot of runs driven in. Okay, the good news, normally I'd say, yeah, you guys are done. The Orioles are done. But I've got some really good news. Matt Wieters was hurt last year, and he normally hits about 25 home runs a year. So if he does that again, that's going to make up for a lot of the home runs from last year, okay? And you've got these other players that have been pretty consistent. Stephen Pierce, who hit 293, 21 home runs. Adam Jones, 281, 29 home runs. That, you know, if they do their job and be consistent as they have in the past, the Orioles should be all right. And they got some chip-in hitters. Jimmy Paradis is 309, 9 home runs. Delman Young, 302, 7 home runs. Alejandro Diaz hit 293, which he normally doesn't, so he careered out. Manny Machado hit 278, 12 home runs. A talented player who, you know, I think the Orioles are counting on him putting up bigger numbers to make up for Cruz and Markakis, which I don't think that he will. He's too young. And we'll show you some major problems with Mr. Machado's swing, okay? But other than him, most of these hitters have made some improvements throughout the past couple of years. And at our team reviews, we are pointing out that most of the hitters in the major leagues are spiraling downward. For the most part, the Orioles are not. There is potential to spiral downward because of the loss of Cruz and Markakis. But we think that the Orioles might be okay because they got so much talent. They had some hitters hurt. Chris Davis, we didn't even mention him because he hit a buck 96. You don't mention people that, you know, hit a buck 96. But prior to that, he's a 270 hitter. And, you know, usually hits between 50 to 30 home runs a year, 30 to 50. Last year, he only hit 26. He had an off year. We're going to discuss his swing and why we think he had an off year also, okay? But, you know, I think the Orioles general manager and the office people are expecting Chris Davis to come back and Wieters to do well. And they're kind of banking on Machado, too, to cover for Nelson Cruz's loss of, you know, home runs and RBIs and all that sort of stuff, which it's a strong possibility, to tell you the truth. So Orioles, I wouldn't put yourself in panic mode whatsoever. Okay? Now, there is a little bit of disarray within the Orioles coaching staff. Okay? Jim Presley's been with them for 4 years. Okay? Normally, a hitting coach lasts maybe 1 to 2 years. So Jim Presley, has he been responsible for the team's improvement? They've been in the top 10 the last couple of years. Prior to that, when he first got the job, you know, they were ranked like 20th in the MLB. Rumor has it that it was his choice, Coach Presley's choice, to want to downgrade to be a minor league coordinator or work in the minor leagues again. Okay? We don't know why, but we could speculate that there's maybe a lot of pressure on him because, you know, the Orioles players do slump a lot. Their on-base percentage isn't as good, although their power numbers are good. And maybe he was feeling a little bit of pressure on that. Or if he's smart to get out of that position, if he halfway knows what he's talking about, and we don't know who Jim Presley is or how good he is, but maybe the players weren't listening to him. Maybe he got bored. Maybe he was feeling too much pressure. And you know, if you're feeling too much pressure, going down to the minor leagues is good because there's no pressure. You have fun. Usually the guys listen to you. And if you think you can make a difference, that's a good place to make a difference. You really got to know what you're talking about if you want a major league hitter to really hone in on you and listen to you as a hitting coach. So who knows what went on there, but it sounds like Presley, the hitting coach, wanted to make this happen. Okay? And it's kind of dangerous because the Orioles are one of the teams that have actually improved over the years. Okay? So now they're bringing in hitting coach Scott Coolbaugh from the Texas Rangers organization. Okay? And, you know, this Scott Coolbaugh, he has 1 year as a hitting coach. I think he was like an interim hitting coach for the Texas organization back when Texas, maybe about 5-7 years ago, was like the lead hitting team. Okay? So he got the job and they did really, really good that year. They were like number one in a lot of different categories. And then if you're into drama or soap opera stuff, they got rid of him, okay? Or they, you know, they activated him to a minor league role again. And they got Dave Magadan from Boston Red Sox to come in and take over the hitting job with the Texas Rangers, okay? And if you know anything about Dave Magadan, please go see our Texas Rangers team review, okay? We're not too high on Dave Magadan, okay? We called him a gold miner, okay? And he's kind of a hitting destroyer type of guy. Destroyed the San Diego Padres. They came in last place under his tutelage. And then he luckily got a job with the Boston Red Sox right on the year that they won the World Series. So he really had nothing to do with that. All the players were in place. And then he destroyed that lineup within the next 5 years, Magadan did. Boston went like from one of the best hitting teams to one of the worst. And we know what Magadan teaches, and we know that he's a hands-on mechanical teacher, and we know exactly what he did with those hitters. So then he went down to Texas, and he gets the job over this Coolbaugh who has put up big numbers just because he has a bigger name. What do we say about the major leagues? Most importantly, results are not the most important thing. It is image. So they got Magadan in because he had an image of being a World Series type of guy because he was on that team. He hit the gold mine, as to say. And they did not pay attention to what he actually does with hitters. He made the Texas Rangers into a situational hitting team, a power hitting team into a situational hitting team. And they've had, under his tutelage, the worst years in the past 10-15 years over there in Texas. So Coolbaugh may have been able to restore the Rangers and keep them where they were, but You know, he got pushed out, and now the Orioles came knocking on his door. Okay? So he gets the job. We don't know how good he is, because when you work with the Texas Rangers, the air is so thin out there, the ball really flies out. And he only worked for 1 year, so we don't know how good he is. We know he worked in the minor league organization, and those guys are the hide-behinders, okay? Okay, because there's no stats to tell anybody how good or bad that they are, okay? So we will see what Scott Coolbaugh can do with the Orioles with some of their good hitters out to free agency, okay? Now, this guy is noted as the play it safe hitting coach. Kind of leaves guys alone. He works within their system, with what they've been doing, with their approach. He's not too pushy. Players really like him because of that. Which tells me, as a hitting coach, is he really doesn't know a lot about hitting, but he knows just enough, and he's a cool enough guy to kind of keep it light, and that way he won't get blamed for too much of anything. The players will like him, and he can concentrate on mental approach and all that sort of stuff. So he is safe. He's the safe. So we can't really say anything bad about that. So, you know, I don't think the Orioles, if you're an Orioles fan, you're not in too much of a dangerous situation. I don't think he's going to be able to help, but I don't think he's really going to hurt very much. And the players like him, so, maybe some of the players he can get the best out of. I don't know. Okay? We'll see. This is the true test for Scott Coolbaugh within the next 2 years. We'll find out in the next year, but especially 2 years, what this guy is all about. But, you know, we meet these guys all the time. They are the play-it-safe guys, play nice with everybody, be politically correct, and you can probably keep your job unless something goes terribly wrong. Okay? So that's where you're at with that, Orioles. And it's too bad that he couldn't stay with the Texas Rangers. I think he would have been in a better situation with that. All right? So, we noticed, though, that a lot of the teams that need hitting coaches, they'll go to the Texas Rangers organization because they think the hitting coaches over at Texas are better because they're a Moneyball hitting team, usually, until Magadan got over there, because they put big numbers, the air is thinner, okay? So they go and they sweep up all those hitting coaches, minor league coaches and stuff like that over there. And then they sweep up the Athletic A's, or the Oakland A's, because they're the Moneyball hitting team. They have been for the past 15 years. The term Moneyball is very popular, so they want Moneyball type of hitting coaches in there, even though they don't know what they're doing type of thing. It's all the general manager, Billy Bean, that gets all the players for the Oakland A's. Has nothing to do with development at all. So then these Oakland A's, minor league guys get some major league jobs, and they don't do anything special, okay? So, the Rangers and Oakland are like two teams, I would have to say, that teams go after as far as hitting coaches are concerned, okay? Which is probably why Coolbaugh, he probably wouldn't have got the job if he wasn't with the Texas Rangers organization there. So we've got, I think they're really banking on this Manny Machado, who's a very young guy. And if you head to my Moneyball Hitter Magazine website, we're going to do a video analysis on him. He's really young. He's got a high elbow, and we know that the high elbow in a batter's stance creates big-time slumps and deletes about half as much of the power out of the hitter. So this guy is very athletic, potentially can hit 30 to 40 home runs. He only hits 12, about a 270 hitter. He just got knee surgery. If he doesn't fix these problems, he's not going to get any better whatsoever, and he's going to be very much prone to a lot of slumps throughout the rest of his career. okay? And he'll never reach his potential. You got to bring that back elbow down, Manny. And that's a lesson to you guys, you know, you coaches that are watching this or you players. If you got a high back elbow, it's taking your potential away. And then we got Chris Davis, who needs to have a big year for the Orioles. And we have noticed that he is taking a longer stride on his approach to the ball when striking the ball, which makes his legs very long and takes away a lot, you know, some of his hip power, which is why he lost some power this past year, and takes away the control of his swing also. So the eyes bounce up and down, strike out a lot, go in a slump. He had a .196 last year. So he's got to get back to, he's got a great swing. He's got that upward, nice backward tilt swing that we like here at Moneyball. But if you got, if your stance is either too wide or your stride is too long, it just messes everything up. And it makes the effective rotational swing ineffective. And that's exactly what happened, you know, with Chris Davis. Can the hitting instructor Coolbaugh fix that? I doubt it, okay? But Chris Davis really needs to get back to where he was last year. So the Orioles, you lost some big hitters last year. You really did. And everything's got to go right for you with all your hitters that you got left over and some of the guys that were injured last year. You know, everything's got to go right. Everybody's got to hit to their potential or what they have been the past couple years. Guys like Machado and Chris Davis have to pick it up. And then I think you'll be all right. But if not, I think it could really all fall apart on you. Okay? And we see this a lot with our team review. So we suspect that the team review for next year isn't going to be as good because you really didn't pick up any free agent hitters. So you're relying on the ones that you got. You're lucky, though, Orioles. You are a Moneyball hitting team, top 10, okay? So whenever you lose a couple players, sometimes you could afford to, okay? But, you know, you're in a tough division. You're in a tough division. So, you know, you got to keep at the level that you're at or better, and you really can't afford to slide beyond the top 10 in the major leagues, or else you're really not going to make the playoffs unless your pitching staff is unbelievable. Okay, so that's a review on the Baltimore Orioles. Little drama involved there, a lot of changes with the pitch with the hitting coaches and stuff. Not much of a big problem. But, you know, we still like the Orioles' chances and potential for disaster, though, if the players, you know, if there's more injuries and stuff like that. Okay, Mike Huber over and out. We will see you next time. Please like our page and our video if you like what you hear. Thank you. Take care.